because we are watching this big winter mess make its way through Central Florida.
It's going to be a very interesting dynamic.
Yeah.
Okay. And there's nothing, I want to be very clear. I'm not forecasting snow in Orlando.
No.
And nothing here is set in stone, but I want to show you kind of this unique weather setup that at least has our antennas raised a little bit. All right. So you've got lots of moisture and a lot of cold air over top of us, right? But notice that the forecast model, this is Tuesday night. 9 p.m. Still showing rain in our area. Snow happens from time to time in the I-10 corridor. But where it gets interesting is this next storm system here. As it crosses over, you have to understand that meteorologically, areas of low pressure rotate counterclockwise. And so that's going to feed more moisture, but on the backside, grab colder air and drive it in. And that is where we could be talking about that kind of rain snow line dipping just a little bit. So what I want to do is show you, this is the European computer forecast model. I have temperatures on the map and then I've got precipitation. All right, so 7 a.m. Tuesday, it's going to be a little crummy. I'm just going to be honest with you. Temperatures in the 40s, 50s and rain. So that means we're going to have the winter rain gear handy. Through the day Tuesday, highs will get into the 50s, maybe 60s, and rain still around. 9 p.m. Tuesday, temperatures start to drop. It's still raining. But 7 a.m. Wednesday, as temperatures are dropping with colder air diving in, notice the readings here around the villages in Ocala, 33, 34. So we're hovering around freezing, and that's where the European model is dropping that rain snow line down further. Keep in mind the American GFS keeps it up to the north. I just wanted to show this one to you just to kind of give you an idea. It all depends on the timing of that cold air moving in. So definitely something that we'll have to watch. Either way, by midday Wednesday, that moisture moves out and it's just kind of like a bitter chill. But it's also not just the surface temperature that we have to worry about in terms of precipitation types. If there's any warm air in the column of the atmosphere, you could be looking at freezing rain or even sleet. So we've got a lot of time to watch the computer models, and certainly we're going to be doing just that. But remember, in addition to timing out that cold air, computer model trends are your friends. That's where we get confident in any kind of scenario.